sixth grade, module six, lesson 18, problem set. Number one, the following histogram shows the amount of coal produced by state for the 20 largest coal producing states in 2011. So it's start off by noticing that it's for 20 data points. Many of these states produced less than 50 million tons of coal, but one state produced over 400 million tons, Wyoming. So we can see that on the chart. So one state produced 400 million, and most of the states produced less than 50 million. So we can see that right here. The vast majority of the data is from 0 to 50. For the histogram, which one of the three sets of summary measures could match the graph? For each choice that you eliminate, give at least one reason for eliminating the choice. All right, let's start with A. So the minimum is 1, which could be possible. The maximum is 410, also could be possible, because there's 1 over here and 410. Let's see, quartile 1 is at 12. So we know that there are, let's see, there's one data point there. There's one data point there. Only two data points there and one data point there. So there are only 4 out of the 20 data points are greater than 50. So that's important to remember. There are 16 data points out of the 20 in the that are produced less than 50 million tons of coal. So it does make sense that quartile 1 would be about 12 because the vast majority of the data is less than 50. So median being 36, I feel like that's realistic because also it's within this range. Quartile 3 says it's at 57, which would be about right here. So quartile 3 would be the middle of the 15th and 16th data points, which we know those are going to lie within here. 15 and 16th data points would be right about there. So it's going to be less than 50. So I can eliminate A. So I'm going to say A doesn't work. So A doesn't work because quartile 3 must be less than 50, since both the 15th and 16th ordered observations or data points are less than 50. Okay, so let's look at B. So the minimum is 2, so that could be possible. I'll use a different color to analyze B. Minimum could be 2, quartile 1, 13.5. So again, everything should kind of fall between 0 and 50. Median, 27.5, that would work. Quartile 3, 44, so that's more realistic. It falls between the 0 and 50 mark, but more towards the end, because it is the 75th percentile, basically. The maximum could be 439, so that works, that's in there. Mean 54.6. I would say that that could be true since we do have this very large outlier that would bring the mean up to a higher number than just being in here, because that 436 is really going to throw things off. And then the mean average deviation could be 52.36. I agree, that would work. So from what I see, I think that B is the correct answer, but let's double check with C first. Okay, so C, the minimum is 10. Okay, well, it could be. The quartile 1 is 37.5. Okay, that seems a little high considering that's only, 37.5. That seems a little high considering it's only quartile 1, but technically could work. Median 62, again, that seems too high because since the median is the middle number, so that should be the number between 10th and 11th data point, and we know those both are in here because the first 16 data points are in there. So I know C can't work. Let's say C doesn't work. Work because the median would be between the 10th and 11th data points. And they both fall between 0 and 60, or 0 and 50. So what was it? What did they say? 62 is too high. Okay. Number two, the heights rounded to the nearest inch of the 41 members of the 2012-2013 University of Texas men's swimming and diving team are shown in the dot plot below. Okay, so there's 41 members. 41 dots are shown there, one for each member. Use the dot plot to determine the five-number summary, minimum, lower quartile, median, upper quartile, and maximum for the data set. Okay, so for A, let's start with minimum, maximum, then we're going to have median, so quartile 1, median, quartile 3. So we'll start with minimum and maximum. These are the easiest. Minimum 66, maximum 80. Okay, let's find the median. So I'm just going to cross off until we find the middle. So we know there's 41, so you could divide that in half and find like the 20 and a half one, but I just like to cross off. I'm gonna start by crossing off 10 on each side. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Okay, now I'm gonna do 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, now let's do 4. So I'm going to start from the top here. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. And so we have these three left. I'm just going to cross off. So the middle one is right there. That's the middle. And that is at 73. So the median is 73. Now we need to find... Let's see, so this one is the median. I'm gonna erase around. So I can find quartile 1 and quartile 3. If you want, you could have also written all these numbers out and found the median that way. All right, I'm gonna start with quartile 3 since it's erased. Okay, so this was the middle right there. So let's start by, I'm going to go 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Let's do 3. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. And then 1, 1. So the median is going to be right in the middle of those, but that's the same number. So that would be 75 for quartile 3. And let's find... Still didn't erase totally. Okay. So let's do the same thing to find quartile 1. So basically finding the median of the first half. So cross off 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Let's do 3. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. And then 1. So we're left with these two, but the middle of them is just 71. So we have 71. So there's our five-number summary. B, based on this dot plot, make a histogram of the new of the heights using the following intervals, 66 to 60, less than 68, 68 to less than 70, and so on. Okay, so let's get our histogram going here. So we want to start at 0, and let's just start over here at 66, and it wants us to go by 2s. So So we need to go all the way up to 80. 70, 72, 74, 76, 78, 80. I'll even do 82. Okay. And then the frequency of how often it occurs, these are just people, so one person. Each dot only represents one data point. So it looks like it range from anywhere from one to the most is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. But we go in twos. So let's go maybe like up to 12 or 14. So again, I'm going to go by twos. 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14. Okay, so between 0 and 66, we don't have any. Let me erase it again so we can see the dots better. Okay, so between 0 and 66, we have 0. From 66 to 68, so the next interval, but less than 68, we have 2. So I'm going to go, I'll draw it up to 2. So there's that interval. From 68 to less than 70, so from here to here, we have 2. 68, one on 68, and one on 69. It's going to stay consistent here. Should be even. From between 70 and 72. So the next group is these two. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. We have 7. So we're going to take it up to about there. Between 72 and 74. So 72, 73. We have this big group, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. So all the way, take it all the way up to 12. And then between 74 and 76, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So now it's getting a little lower. Data's starting to go back down. 76 and 77 would be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And 79, there's only one. And then there's one on 80 as well. So that is what our histogram should look like. So let's... The only thing I missed are my labels. Let's label it. So this would be height, but in inches. This is frequency. And then let's just call it height of Texas men's swim team. Swim and dive team. All right, number 3. Data on the weight in pounds of 143 wild bears are summarized in the histogram below. Which one of the 3 dot plots could be used below could be a dot plot of the bear weight. Explain how you determined which the correct plot is. Okay, so now they've given us dot plots for the information, and we need to figure out which is the correct one. Okay, so let's start with number 1. So it looks like the first one pretty much follows the same kind of, you know, pattern there. I would say they're skewed similarly, which I can't really say for this one. So I don't think dot plot 2 works because they're not, it's more symmetric than dot plot one. And dot plot three wouldn't work because the data doesn't even start until 200. So it skips out on everything over here. So dot plot three doesn't work. I'm going with dot plot one. So let's say dot plot one is the correct choice. Dot plot two doesn't have the same shape. As the histogram, dot plot three doesn't even begin until 200 and the histogram has data from 0 to 50. Or let's just say from 0 to 200. And that's the end.